This conference will now be recorded.
Right, let's start. Hope it's audible to everyone. Okay. Right. So, yeah, yesterday we have seen the role of ABAP consultant in what SAP projects. We have discussed the different stages in what development of what objects. Okay, so in continuation to that, let us understand the concept of what T-codes. Okay, so T-codes, this T-code stands for what? Transaction codes. Okay, T-code stands for transaction codes. So what exactly is this T-code means? As we know, SAP contains different modules. Okay, SAP contains different modules. For example, assume that we have SAP FICO. Okay, so this is a module related to which department? Finance department. Okay, then we have what? SAP SD, sales and what? Distribution. Okay, like this, SAP contains what? Different modules. Okay, so assume that related to finance department, for example, assume that we have some 100 different transactions. Okay, so for each of these transactions, okay, for each of these transactions, SAP will provide what? One T code. So if you assume that related to FICO module, we have some 100 transactions. So how many T codes SAP will provide? 100 T codes, 100 transaction codes. Similarly, if you take SAP SD module, assume that this has got some 150 different transactions. So again, SAP will provide what? 150 T codes. Please mute your speakers. Ram, please mute your speakers. Ram, can you please mute your speakers?
Yes, yes, mate.
Yeah.
1 minute. Please.
Yeah, yeah.
Something.
Okay. So if there are some 150 transaction codes, how many T codes SAP will provide? 150 T codes. So first of all, what is the meaning of a transaction? Okay, transaction is nothing but what? It's a collection of screens where you perform some business operations. For example, withdrawing an amount from ATM is also what? A transaction. So every transaction, in order to perform a transaction, the user might navigate what? Multiple screens. So for example, assume like this, suppose, okay, try to understand this. We have a transaction. Okay, in order to perform the transaction, assume that we need to navigate some 4 screens. Okay, every transaction will have what? One initial screen. Okay, so what SAP will do is, whatever the T code SAP has given for that particular transaction, this T code is always associated with what? Initial screen. Means whenever I execute my T code, it is going to display me the initial screen of what? Transaction. Again, a transaction might contain n number of screens. Okay, you will not have the T code for each and every screen. Okay, you will have the T code on behalf of what? Transaction. T code is always linked with the initial screen of what? Transaction. Okay, so like this, every SAP module contains a different number of what? T code. So if you are a FICO consultant, we are expected to remember all the T codes related to what? FICO module. If I am a SD consultant, I should know all the T codes related to what? SD module. Similarly, if you are a MM consultant, we should know all the T codes related to what? This MM module. Okay. Similarly, ABAP is also a technical module in what? SAP. Okay. What is the purpose of this ABAP? It is used for what? Development purpose. Whatever the transactions that we require in our SAP, okay, we need to develop them. So that development is carried out by using what? This particular ABAP. So in order to develop those objects, yesterday I told you whatever we develop in ABAP environment, we call them as what? Objects. Okay, in order to develop that particular objects, we require what? Some tool. So ABAP is used for what? Object development. Okay, ABAP is used for what? Object development. Okay, so to develop these objects, what we require? To develop the objects, we require what? Tools. Okay, to develop objects, we require what? Tools. So just try to understand. In other modules, I am calling them as what? Transactions. Okay, whereas coming to this ABAP module, I am calling it as what? Tools. So we require what? Tools. Okay, and again, each tool, so there are n number of tools provided by what? SAP. Okay, there are many tools provided by SAP, like we have ABAP editor. Okay, we have something called as what? Function builder. Okay, we have something called as screen painter. Okay, we have menu painter. Okay, we have something form painter, like that. We'll come across what many tools in what ABAP module. Okay, for each of these tools, SAP will provide what? One transaction code. Okay, so for ABAP editor, the T code is what? SE38. For function builder, the T code is what? SE37. For screen painter, the T code is what? SE51. Again, for menu painter, you'll have something what? SE41. For form painter, we'll have what? SE71. So what I am trying to say is, every module in SAP will have what? T codes. Okay, it is not possible for a consultant to remember the T codes of what? All the modules. Okay, to remember the T codes of what? All the modules. So if you're an ABAP consultant, we are expected to know the T codes related to what? ABAP. Okay, plus depending on the experience, we'll get exposure to what? The other frequently used T codes of what? Other modules. Okay, similarly, if you're a FICO consultant, we are expected to know the T codes related to what? FICO module. Again, SD consultant should know the T codes related to what? SD module. Okay, so T code is nothing but what? It provides what? Navigation to a transaction. Means whenever I run the T code, the T code is going to open me what? Initial screen of the transaction, or I can say initial screen of what? Tool. In ABAP environment, instead of calling it as a transaction, we are calling it as what? Tool. What is the purpose of this tool? Tools are used for what? Developing the objects. Whatever we develop in ABAP environment, we call them as what? Objects. Hope it's clear. Okay, so in simple terminology, a T code nothing but what? Provides what? It provides navigation. Okay, provides navigation to a transaction or what? A tool. So in functional modules, we call it as transaction. In ABAP environment, we call it as what? Tool. It is also a transaction, but we generally call it as what? Tool, because we are using that particular tool for developing some objects. So ABAP provides different types of what? Tools. For each of these tools, SAP will provide what? Some transaction codes. Okay, so overall in SAP, you'll have thousands of T codes. We cannot remember all the T codes. As an ABAP consultant, we should remember all the T codes related to what? ABAP module. Okay, so as part of our course, as part of this core ABAP, OOPS ABAP and cross applications, okay, we'll be touching around 80 to 90 T codes. Okay, 80 to 90 T codes, which you are expected to remember. Those are the T codes which we frequently use for most of the development process. Okay, so I think already the list is there. One second, let me open that. Yeah, if you observe this. Yeah, okay, so you can observe here ABAP related T codes. Okay, so related to core ABAP, related to the basic ABAP, these are some of the T codes which we use frequently. Okay, so I just listed
out. Will now be recorded.
Yeah, so I just listed out what? The list of what T codes which are very frequently used, which are very frequently used. So I gave some 28 to 30 T codes to the basic ABAP. And as an ABAP consultant, we are also expected to remember the T codes related to what? other functional models, some frequently used T codes. So I just listed out those things also, but doesn't mean that we should know only these T codes. Okay. When you come to cross applications, we'll come across many T codes. So overall, as part of our course, we'll be discussing around 80 to 90 T codes, which are expected to remember forever. Hope it's clear to everyone. So T code stands for transaction codes. Any questions on this? Okay, right. One second, yeah. So we understood the purpose of what T code, and we know that ABAP is used for our development purpose. Okay, so how do we connect to the SAP system? So just try to understand. So this is your SAP software. Okay, this is an SAP software. SAP server, where what happens in this SAP server, it will contain what application server and what database server. So when I say SAP server, it includes what application server and what database server. Okay, database server is what? It is nothing but it is a place where we store the data permanently. Application server means where the entire processing will take place. All the calculations will be executed in what? Application server. So assume that we have the SAP server. Okay, so we need to connect to this particular server. How do we connect to this server? In all the client machines, okay, you will have one software called as GUI, SAP GUI, graphical user interface. In all the client machines, SAP GUI software will be installed. Just like if you want to access any website, we require what? Browsers. We require Internet Explorer, we require Mozilla or Google Chrome. Okay, similarly, to connect to the SAP server, we need to connect to this SAP server through what? SAP GUI. So in all the client machines, SAP GUI software will be installed, graphical user interface. Whenever this SAP GUI software is installed, okay, you'll get this particular what icon. What is this? This one, SAP logon pad. So we call it as what? SAP logon pad. SAP logon pad will be installed, okay, whenever we install what? SAP GUI. So through this SAP logon pad only we'll be connecting to what? SAP server. Am I clear? So in all the client machines we need to install what? SAP GUI. So if you take a laptop, okay, in our laptop, if you are installing SAP, means what you have to, in our laptop, we need to install application server, database server, as well as a GUI software, okay? Because it's only a one system, you need to install all the front-end application as well as what? Back-end system, okay? Right? But this is a general setup in the companies, okay? You'll have an SAP server. To this SAP server, in order to connect in all the client machines, we'll be installing what? SAP GUI. Okay, through this GUI only we'll be connecting to what? SAP server. So here also, so on my desktop I am having the SAP logon pad. When I double click, you'll get the logon pad here. Now here in our case we are having multiple servers, we are maintaining multiple servers. Okay, so let me try to connect it to what? SAP system. So my requirement is we want to start the development, so I want to develop a simple object. Okay, so here these are the different servers available in our setup. I'll be choosing this particular EHP7 and enhancement pack, ECC 6.0 with enhancement pack. Okay, EHP7 is a what version here? So we have different versions here. We have 4.7, 6.0, ECC 6.0, Enterprise Central Component, okay, EHP7, EHP8 also we have, okay, understood. So I'll be choosing this EHP7, right? So choose a server whichever you want to connect. So I'll be choosing EHP7. I'll click on what? Log on. So let's see whether we're able to connect or not. Yeah, right, so I'm able to connect to my server. So I repeat, in order to connect to the SAP server, what you have to do, we need to install what? SAP GUI software, graphical user interface. Whenever we install SAP GUI, you'll get this particular logon pad. Okay, when you double click on that, you'll get this particular window. In that, choose your server. So in my case, we have many servers. I'll be choosing what? EHP 7. I'll click on what? Logon. Okay, I'll click on logon. Done. So I'm getting the logon screen. I'm getting the logon screen here. So you can observe here, welcome to the IDS ECC 6.0 including EHP 7. ECC stands for Enterprise Central Component. EHP stands for what? Enhancement Pack. Okay, Enhancement Pack. Right, IDS stands for what SAP has done is for what training purpose they have released this version, IDS, International Demonstration Education System. Okay, so this is a what for training purpose they are given this version. Done. So in the logon screen you can observe here, it is asking the client number. What is the client number defaulted here? 800. So first let us understand what is the meaning of this particular client. Okay, right, so yesterday I told you that in every SAP project, what is the landscape, minimum landscape will follow? You'll have three systems: development client, quality client, and what? Production client. Development client access is given to whom? To the development team, that is to the ABAP consultant. And quality system access will be given generally to what? Testers. And production system access given to the end users where the live business will be executed. Okay, so I repeat, we have development client, quality client, production client. Again, project to project the landscape might be different, but in every project you'll have what? Minimum this three clients. So what happens is, for each of these systems, that is for development, quality and production, the basis consultant, I told you already, we have one module called as basis, which is related to administration. Okay, what the basis consultant will do is, for each of these systems, they will assign some client number. Okay, they'll assign some client number. So let me explain that one second. Yeah, see here. Just try to understand. Assume that you are working for some company, Wipro, okay, and Wipro is implementing SAP for which customer? Tata customer. So for Wipro, the customer is what? Tata. So in the Tata project, what is the landscape followed? Development client, quality client, and what? Production client. Okay, so what the basis consultant, the administrator, will do is, at the beginning of the project implementation, they will assign some client numbers here. Okay, so assume that in the Tata project, for a development client, what is the client number assigned? 250. For quality client, what is the client number? 500. For production client, what is the client number? 750. So client number ranges from 000 to 999. Client number can be any number between 000 to what? 999. Okay, so who will have access to the development client? ABAP consultant. So assume that in the Tata project, there are 10 ABAP consultants assigned to a development client. Again, each consultant will have their own user ID and password. So for 10 ABAP consultant, 10 user IDs will be created. Who will create this user ID? Who will create this logon credentials? It is done by what? Basis consultant only. Okay, again, who will have access to the quality client? Access might be given to what? Testers. So how many user IDs will be created here? Assume that there are 5 testers. So 5 user IDs will be created for those, each of those what? Testers. Again, production client access given to what? End users. Assume that there are 10 end users working in the production client. Again, 10 user IDs will be created in the production client. Okay, so creating these users, creating the client, assigning the users to the client is the job of what? Basis consultant. As a ABAP consultant or as a functional consultant, you need not worry about this creating the client and creating the users. It is a job of what? Administrator only. Okay, it is a job of administrator only. Done. So similarly, assume that in the same Wipro company, there is another project running, that is Reliance. So who is the other customer for Wipro? Reliance. So in the Reliance client also, assume that we have development client, quality client, and production client. So what is the development client number here? 350. Here the quality client number is 550. So project to project, the client numbers might be different. it can be any number between what, 000 to what, 999. So we are not bothered about how to create this client, okay, where to create this client, how to create these credentials, all those things. It is a job of what, administrator. So in simple terminology, in SAP, client is nothing but what, a 3-digit number ranging from what, 000 to what, 999. So in the Tata project, if I am referring to the client number 500, it means what, I am referring to which system, quality system. Similarly, in the Reliance project, if I am referring to the client 710, means I am referring to which system, production system. So a client is used for what, a unique identification of a system in the project. It is used for unique identification of a system in the project landscape. Okay, so each client will contain what, n number of what, users. That user can be in the form of a web consultant, it can be in the form of functional consultant, or it can be in the form of testers, or it can be in the form of what, end users. Okay, so each client is used for unique identification of a system in the landscape. So why we are discussing all these things is, whenever I'm trying to log on to my SAP server, what is the client number defaulted here? 800. So in the real time also, in the real time also, okay, as an ABAP consultant, what you have to do, whenever I open my logon pad, try to understand, whenever I open my logon pad, what happens? You will get the logon pad. On that particular logon pad, it will show the systems, what, development client, quality client, and production client. Okay, development client, quality client, and production client. So since I'm an ABAP consultant, what is the client I have to choose? Development client. So assume that this is my development client. Assume that this is my development client. I'll click on logon. So what is the client number displayed here? 800. So you need not worry about this client number. That will be defaulted here. Okay, if I am a tester, some other client number might be what, displayed here, because I will be logging into what, quality system. Done. So the client number is displayed by default here, and here I need to give the user ID and what, password. So whenever a consultant is assigned to a project, every consultant will be given the user ID and what, password. So here also, let me give the user ID. I'll give the user ID as what, SAP user, and password. Let me give the password as some password, whatever is there in my system. So I'm giving the password, and it is asking the logon language. In which language you want to log on? What is the long language shown here? EN. So what SAP has done is, okay, SAP has provided this software in what, multiple languages. Means it is multilingual. Means for all the international languages, suppose for English, okay, for English they gave the language key as what, EN. For German, they gave the language key as what, DE. Like this, for every, almost for most of the international languages, SAP has provided what, language key. So if I am a user from Germany, try to understand, if I am a user from Germany, I don't understand English, I expect all the screens to be displayed in what, German language. So what I'll do, I'll choose a logon language as what, DE. Means all the screens will be displayed in what, German language. Okay, so if I want to see that in English, I'll be giving what, EN. Even if I don't give anything here, the default language configured is what, English. Okay, if you give or doesn't give, doesn't matter. Understood? So depending on the language which you want to show the screens, that language key we need to provide. If I know French, I'll be giving it as what, FR. Provided if that language is set up only, it will show. Otherwise it will not show. Okay, FR indicates what, French. So I'll be going for what, EN. Understood? So I repeat once again. Client is nothing but what? It is a 3-digit number used for what? Unique identification of a system in the project landscape. And every consultant will have their own user ID and what, password. I need to give the user ID and password. Done. And in which language you want to log on? I am giving it as what? English. Done. So this is the initial things we need to provide. After giving all these things, let me press enter. Right, so it is going to validate whether it is a registered user or not. Done. So I got the initial screen. Okay, so whether I am an ABAP consultant or a FICO consultant or SD consultant, HR consultant, MM consultant, everyone will get the same screen. This initial screen of SAP, we call it as what? SAP Easy Access Screen. From this screen only, we will be navigating to what? Different transactions or different what? Different tools. Okay. So this is the initial screen. Let us understand this screen first. What is this screen called as SAP Easy Access Screen? So let us understand the screen. We have this menu, edit, favorites, extras. This is called as what? Menu bar. This terminology is important. Okay. So this is called as what? Menu bar. And below that, we have one cursor blinking here. We have one cursor blinking here. This is called as command field. Command field where the user will give the T codes. Okay. So if I want to open, what is the T code for ABAP editor? SE38. What is this ABAP editor means? You can assume similar to Turbo C editor. So if you know C language, where do we develop the C language programs? In the Turbo C editor. Okay. So similar to Turbo C editor, here we have what? ABAP editor. What is the T code for this? SE38. So in this command field, okay, we have to give the T code. SE38 and press enter. Okay, we'll come back to that. Done. So this is command field and this is called as standard toolbar. We have some buttons here. Back button, log off button, print button, find button. This is called as standard toolbar. First is menu bar, then we have what? Standard toolbar, and there is some title displayed here. SAP Easy Access, we call it as title bar. And below that we have some buttons here. Other menu, create role. This is called as application toolbar. These terminologies are very important for ABAP consultant. Functional consultant need not worry about that. But as an ABAP consultant, we are responsible for managing these toolbars. Going forward, we will add our own buttons on the application toolbar. So when I say application toolbar, I am referring to this area. When I am saying standard toolbar, I am referring to this area. When I am saying menu bar, I am referring to this area. So menu bar, standard toolbar, title bar, application toolbar, this is my screen area, and what? Status bar, something like this. Okay, this is my SAP Easy Access, menu bar, standard toolbar. As part of standard toolbar only, you'll have what? Command field, then we have title bar, application toolbar, screen area, and what? Status bar. Okay, so this is your SAP Easy Access screen. Here the cursor is blinking. This is called as command field where you will provide the T code. So what is my requirement here? My requirement is I want to develop a simple program. Again, we should not call it as a program. Always pronounce it as what? Object. Whatever we develop, we call it as object. So I want to develop an object which has to display me the message, welcome message. Means whenever I run my program, whenever I execute my object, it has to display me the welcome message. Okay, it has to display the welcome message. So let us see how to do it. So what you have to do here, this is my initial screen. In the command field, I want to develop an object. So for developing the objects, for developing the programs, okay, for developing the programs, we require what? ABAP editor. What is the T code for this ABAP editor tool? SE38. So like that, during the course, we'll be seeing all these T codes. So by the end of the course, we'll be using around 80 to 90 T codes. So doesn't mean that in the real time also, we'll be using only those 80 to 90 T codes. Those are frequently used T codes. I can say 90 to 95% we'll be using those T codes only. But depending on our experience and exposure, we'll come across what? New T codes. New T codes. But as an ABAP consultant, we'll be using only these T codes. Done. So I'll be choosing what? SE38. So I'll run the T code what? SE38. Press enter. When I press enter, it will open me what tool? ABAP editor. So let me press enter. So it has opened me a tool called as what? ABAP editor. Okay. You can visualize this similar to what? Turbo C editor. In our C, C++, we'll develop our C, C++ programs inside what? Turbo C editor. Done. So it is asking me the program name, nothing but what? Object name. Object name. So before I give the object name, again, we should know some other terminology. We have something called as Okay, we have something called as standard objects, or we call it as what, or we have custom objects. Standard objects means these are provided by what? SAP itself. Okay, these are provided by what? SAP itself means they are built in. Built in the sense, whenever we install SAP software, along with that software, you'll have some built-in objects available, built-in reports, built-in tables. Okay, so all these things are called as what? Standard objects. Means the objects which are available by default along with the software, they are called as what? Standard objects. Okay, so how do we recognize these standard objects? They starts with what? So any object which is starting with other than Z or Y, any object which is starting with other than Z or Y, okay, we call it as what? Standard objects. Okay, standard objects. Okay, whereas if you are developing the new objects, okay, custom objects means what? New objects developed by what? ABAP consultant. Okay, new objects developed by ABAP consultant on behalf of what? Customer. On behalf of what? Customer. So according to our customer specific requirement, we need to develop the new objects. Those new objects, we call it as what? Custom objects, or we call it as what? Z objects. How do we recognize them? With these Z objects or custom objects, we must start with what? Either Z or what? Y. Either Z or what? Y. So this is the differentiation between standard objects and what? Custom objects. So if you take standard objects, these standard objects can be only what? Read and what? Execute. I can read it and I can use it. I can execute it. Okay. To modify, in order to modify this, we need to provide. Okay. We need to provide what? Access key. Okay. You can assume this access key is like a password kind of thing. Okay, which will not be given to what? Consultants. Okay, I can only read and what? Execute. For example, see here. This is my ABAP editor. I'll give one program. Let me give the program as RSTXLDMC. Okay, this is my program name. There are thousands of objects. This is one of the object. What is that? RSTXLDMC. Is it starting with Z or Y? No, it is not starting with Z or Y, it is starting with R, other than Z or Y. So you have to understand this is what? Standard object given by whom? SAP. I'll try to modify this program. So I'll try to click on what? Change. So that's what I told here. In order to change it, in order to modify it, we need to provide what? Access key. So here, after giving the object name, the standard object name, I'll click on change button here. When I click on change, yeah, you can see here, it is asking for what? Access key. It is asking for access key. Nothing but what? A kind of password kind of thing. This access key will not be given to what? Consultants. Understood? If it is really required to modify, yes, we'll get the access key. We can provide the access key and we can start making the changes in the standard object. Otherwise, most of the times, access key will not be given to the consultant. Okay, I can only what? Display it. I can only read it. So let me cancel this. Access refused. Done. So I can only what? Display it. I can only read it. I'll click on display. Yeah, you can see this is the standard program given by what? SAP. I can only display the report. I can only read it. I can only execute it. But I cannot do any changes. I cannot do any changes. Okay. Right. So what is my requirement now? I want to develop a custom object which has to display in the welcome message. So you must start with what? Z or what? Y. So here I'll say, okay, I'll give the program name as something, program one, something. So here you can observe, I am not starting with what? Z or Y. Since I'm not starting with Z or Y, it will assume that as what? Standard object. It will assume that as a standard object. So when I try to create that, when I try to create, it is asking for what? Access key. Understood? That is the reason all the custom objects you must start with what? Z or Y. That is Z or Y. You must start with Z or Y. So let me give the object name as what? Z. Okay, again, don't pronounce it as Z. Okay, since SAP is a German product, they pronounce it as what? Z. Okay, so Z, I'll give the object name as, again, don't say program name. It's a program only, but pronounce it as object. I'll give the object name as something Z630 program 1. Something Z630 program 1. So I am starting with what? Z here, that is Z or what? Y. Since I'm starting with Z here, that is Z, it will not ask for any access key because it will assume that as what? Custom object. So let me just provide the name, some name, but make sure that you start with Z or Y. Done. I'll click on create. Suppose I'll give like this Z630-program1. Okay, -program1. I'll try to click on create. It is giving me an error. What is that? Use underscore as a separator. Okay, it is not allowing me to use what? Hyphen. Let me use @Z630@program1. I'll click on create. Again, it is asking what? Do not use any special characters. So I should not use any special characters. If you want to use any separator, use underscore. But other than underscore, I cannot use any other special characters. So let me not give any underscore also. I give the object name as Z630-program1. I'll click on create. So when I click on create, right? So it is not asking for me any access key. It is assuming that as a custom object. It is asking for the title. Okay. Hope it's clear up to this. Any questions so far before I continue? Any questions so far? Okay, so if there are no questions, yeah, I'll show that, Vamsi, I'll show that. Right, any other, Ram, any questions? Yeah, one minute. Yes. Okay, fine, done. So here, right, so I gave the program name, then I clicked on what? Create. I'm starting with ZRY, it is assuming that is what? Custom object. Okay, done. Then here you have to give the title. Okay, so you can give any title you can give, but always make an habit to provide a meaningful title so that by looking at the title, I can understand the purpose of the object. Okay, so let me give a meaningful title. Something, welcome program, some title I am giving. Then it is asking, acha, in which user I logged in? SAP user, means who is the owner of this object? SAP user, understood? Owner in the sense, the person whoever develops the objects is called as what? Owner. So in this case, this object is getting developed by which user? SAP user. I got the date and language. In which language I am developing? English. Done. Then it is asking type of the object. So in ABAP, objects can be classified into different types here. Okay, we'll be discussing all those objects going forward. Here, when I choose this drop down, you can see here, it is showing me different types of objects. Okay, it is showing different types of objects. So initial 4 or 5 days, we'll be choosing only what? Executable program. Later on during the course, we'll come across all these things. Okay. So I'll choose a type of object as what? Executable program. And don't worry about other things at this stage, not required at this stage. Okay, so just give the title and choose a type of object as what? Executable program. We cannot understand these things at this stage. This thing will be discussed as and when required. As of now, just choose what? Executable program. Done. So I gave the title and the type of the object, then click on what? Save. I'll click on what? Save button. When I click on save button, yeah, it is asking me the package, means it is asking me in which package you want to store this object. What is my object name? Z630 program 1. Z630 program 1. It is asking me the package. You can understand a package is like a directory. A package is like a folder. What is a directory? Collection of files. Collection of files. Similarly, in real time also, in the projects also, whatever the objects you have developed, okay, that objects must be stored inside a transportable package. Okay, yesterday I told you, each object that we develop in the development client should be transported to what? Quality system. And from quality, we have to transport it to a production system. In order to transport the object from one client to another client, the object must be stored inside a transportable package. So you can understand a package like a folder, like a directory, which is a collection of what? Files. Here, package is a collection of what? Objects. Okay. At this stage, I don't know how to create the package, or I don't know where to create the package. Okay. So what I'll do, since I don't have any package at this stage, I'll click on what? Local objects. When I click on the local object, what happens is your object, what is the object name? Z630 program 1. This is my object name. So if I save it in local object, what happens is it will go and store inside a package called as $tmp. $tmp is a default package provided by what? SAP itself. I repeat, since I don't have any package at this stage, I'll click on local object. So internally, what happens? This object will go and sit inside which package? $tmp. The objects which are stored in what? $TMP. The objects which are stored in $TMP cannot be transported. Okay, the objects which are what? Stored in local object cannot be transported. Means here. It's here. Observe here. So where do we do the developments as an ABAP consultant? You will do the developments in what? Development client. So when I'm developing an object, it is asking me to save na. So if I save in what? Local object. Where this object will go and sit inside what? $TMP. What is this $TMP? It is a default package provided by what? SAP. It is a default package provided by SAP. If you store it in $TMP, that is local object, it cannot be transported. Remember, it cannot be transported. That is why in the projects, every object that we develop, that will be stored inside, that has to be stored inside what? Transportable package. If you store it in transportable package, your object will be assigned to something called as what? Change request, or we call it as what? Transport request. If it is assigned to change request, then only I can do the transportation. Transportation is possible. So, but at this stage, we don't know how to create the package. I'll click on what? Local object, because anyhow we are not going to do any transportation here. But in the projects, every object has to be transported from development client to what? Quality client. So during the course, we will see how to create the package, and we'll understand the meaning of this change request, all those things. Till that time, I will store all my objects in what? Local object only, nothing but what? $TMP. So I'll choose what? Local object. And what is the type of this object? What is the type of object I have chosen in the previous step? Executable program. The type of object is executable program. So I'll click on local object. Done. So I got an editor where I can type my object. What is the type of object I have chosen? Executable program. Executable program always starts with what? Report keyword. Okay. Executable program always starts with what? Report keyword. Okay, it always starts with report keyword. Okay, and as I told you yesterday, every statement in ABAP must end with what? Period. That is dot. It indicates what? End of the statement. So what is my requirement here? I want to just display a simple message, welcome message. Okay, so what I have to do, if you take C language, we use printf. If you take C++, we use cout. In ABAP, we have a keyword, we have a statement called as what write statement. So I'll say write. What I want to display, I want to display a string, welcome to SAP. So string is nothing but what? Group of characters, collection of what? Characters. As I told in ABAP, one of the programming rule is what? Strings must be enclosed in what? Single quotes. So in single quotes, unless in single quotes, I'll give the string, group of characters. Welcome to SAP, close the single quotes. Okay. And as I told you yesterday, every statement you have to end with what? Period. So I have to give what? Period. Indicates end of the statement. I will not give the period. Let's see what happens. So write statement is used for what? Displaying the what? Result. You can assume this is similar to what? Printf in what? C language. So I gave the string what? Welcome to SAP. Done. I want to execute my program. So first what you have to do is every object if you want to execute in ABAP, if you want to execute any object, first we need to save. We have to perform this four steps. Right, so in order to execute your program, you have to perform these four things. You have to save, you have to check for the syntax errors, Ctrl F2, activate the object, Ctrl F3, and then execute the object by using what? F8. So this is the object I developed. Once I finish my object, I want to execute that. So first let me save it. On the standard toolbar, you can see we have a button what? Save, Ctrl S. I'll click on this, or I can use a shortcut Ctrl S. Done. I am getting a message on the status bar, program is what? Saved. Then I have to check for the syntax error. How do you check? Control F2. Control F2. So you can observe on the application toolbar. This is your application toolbar. We have a button what? Check, Control F2. I'll click on this check button. Then I got a syntax error. What is the syntax error I got? The last statement is not complete. Period what? Missing. I got a syntax error. The last statement is not complete. Period missing. So every statement in ABAP must end with what? Period. So let me double click on this. If I double click on this, it takes a control to that line where the error is there. In which line the error is there? You can see in the right hand side, 11th line. 11th line, it is showing me the error. Anyway, this is 11th line. If I double click also, it is staying the cursor there only. So what is the correction I need to do? I need to end the statement with what? Dot, that is period. Since I made the changes, again you need to save it. Control S, save, then Control F2, check for what? Syntax errors. What is this? Program is syntactically correct. Program is syntactically correct. Then what is the next step here? We need to activate. So already I told yesterday, every object that we develop must be transported to the next system, not to the quality system. Okay, in order to transport the object from one system to another system, the object must be in active state. The object must be in what? Active state. Okay, so in this case, what is the status of the object here? Inactive. So without activation also, I can directly execute. I can directly say F8, but make an habit to what? Activate, because in the real time every object has to be transported. If you activate only, okay, I can transport from one system to another system. So let me try to activate, Control F3. So when I click on activate, yeah, what is the, there are, I got a window. What is the tab highlighted? Local objects, because I saved it inside what? Local object. What is the object name? Z630 program name 1, which is already selected, which is selected by default. So you need not do anything here. If you would have saved in a package, this would have been highlighted. What is this? Transportable objects. But I saved inside what? Local object. Done. Let me click on this continue button, or I can press enter key. Done. The object is in what? Active state. The object is in active state. Then what I have to do? I need to execute. How do we execute? F8. So on the application toolbar only, you can see we have a button for direct processing. So let me click on F8, I got the result. What is that? Welcome to what? SAP. This screen where the output is displayed, we call it as list processing screen. In ABAP, the output screen is called as what? LPS, list processing screen. So write statement displays the result on what? LPS, list processing screen. Okay, this is a title, welcome program. While creating the program, I gave the title as what? Welcome programs. So I got the title in the title bar as well as on the output screen. What is the message I'm printing? Welcome to SAP. I want to go back to my program. So I'll say what? Back, F3. Every screen in SAP contains this button, back button, F3. I'll click on this. Done. I want to give one more statement. So I'll say what? Write. Welcome to SAP ABAP. So again, I have to give what? End the statement with what? Period. Since I modified my program, let me save it. Control S. Check for syntax errors. Control F2. Activate. Control F3. Done. Enter. Execute. How do we execute? F8. What I got? Welcome to SAP. Welcome to SAP ABAP. I got it in the same line. I got it in the same line. If you want it in the new line, in C, C++, we use slash n. Here we use what? Slash. Just we use what? Slash. Slash indicates what? Here, new line, next line. So since I modified my program, let me save it. Check for syntax error. Activate. Execute. F8. I got the result in the next line. Welcome to SAP and welcome to SAP ABAP. This screen, output screen, we call it as what? LPS, list processing screen. So let me go back after. So this is how you develop the objects in what? ABAP. So just I gave the what? Look and feel of that particular ABAP editor. Okay. So from the next class onwards, we'll be discussing the developments only. We'll be discussing different types of statements. How do we read the input? How do you process the input? What are the options available? How do you check the documentation? All those things we'll discuss from the next class. That is from what? Monday. Next class will be again on what? Monday. Okay. Classes, as I told you, it will be from Monday to what? Friday. Monday to Friday. Next class, again, we'll have it on Monday at 6:30. Any questions for today, you can ask me. Any questions in this part? And I've shared the recordings with everyone. I'll be sharing this also. So the actual development part will start from what? Next class, that is from Monday at 6:30 a.m. Any questions, please ask me. Done. Syed, is the connection is fine for you because you're attending from your workplace?
Yes, yes, sir.
Fine, nah? Okay. Fine.
Okay. Yes.
Right, so I'll wind off then. If you don't have any questions, I'll wind off. We'll continue again on Monday at 6:30. And for practice, see, for practicing, Syed, please mute your speakers. Vamshi, it is hidden in my system. In the next class, I'll take another system. There I'll show. Here it is hidden. We don't have access for that. Okay, it is hidden here. Right. So for practice purpose, Syed, can you please mute your speakers?
Yes.
Yeah. See, for practice purpose, there are two things. One is you need to take remote server access for rental. Okay. So we are only into training. As I told you in the initial class, you need to take it from outside vendor. Okay, so probably today I'll share that vendor details through email. Okay, you can contact them directly by calling them or by through email. They'll charge some, I don't know the exact price, they'll charge some 500 to 700 rupees per month. Okay, so I'll share the vendor details. You can directly access, you can contact them through phone or through email. They'll provide you the test access for 1 or 2 days. If you're having, if you're able to access it without any problem, you can make the payment and they'll extend it for 1 month. Okay, remote server access for rental. Okay, this is one option. Another option is you need to get it installed on your laptop. Get it installed on what? Laptop. So for this, again, you need to physically come to Hyderabad. Okay, you need to physically come to Hyderabad for doing this installation. Okay, I suggest this is the better option. Okay, you can access their server anywhere, from anywhere, wherever you are, you can access, right? Yeah, as I promised, this video recordings, no, video recordings of all classes will be shared, but as I told you, it may not be possible for me to share it on a daily basis. Okay, so weekly twice I'll share. Weekly twice. So when I say weekly twice, if I share it on Wednesday, I'll share the videos of what? Monday, Tuesday and what? Wednesday. And then if I share the next class, next again on Saturday, I'll share the videos of what? Thursday and what? Fridays. Okay. And these videos will be accessible till the end of the course. Till end of the course. End of the course means, suppose if the Korabab goes for 2.5 months. So for all these 2.5 months, you will have access to this particular videos. Okay, so like that. Any further questions? Right. So today what I'll do is I'll share the today's video also, or today or most probably tomorrow. This vendor details, I'll mail it to everyone through email. Okay, so you can contact them directly and you can take the system on rental. Okay, they'll tell you the process how to access their server remotely. Everything they'll communicate through email. Just follow the steps and try to connect to their server for rental purpose. Anyhow, we have not started the development part. We'll be starting the actual development from Monday onwards. So after Monday, you can take their server access for rental and check it for 1 or 2 days. If you're comfortable, then you can communicate. You need to pay the first month rent as advance. They'll give it for what? 1 month. Okay. So every month you can extend by paying this amount. Okay. So how many months your requirements? It depends on your practice. You may require it 3 months, 4 months, or 5 months, whatever it is. Okay. Any other questions? Next class will be on Monday around 6:30 a.m. Done. So I'll wind up then. We'll continue on Monday then. Ciao.